Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to thread your needle and two different ways to tie a knot and a third way in case the first two methods don't really work for you. So the first thing you want to do is thread your needle, which means getting your thread through the eye of the needle. And we are going to use this slightly thicker embroidery thread and a bigger needle than your typical hand sewing needles. So what you want to try to do is hold it down by the end of your thread and not out here, because there's no way you're going to be able to get it in there. It's just going to flop around on you. So hold it nice and close to the end, and I'm kind of pinching my thread so that it's all in one little bunch, and I'm going to try to get that through the eye. All of those little individual threads need to go through. Another thing you can try, if this isn't working so well, is you can take some scissors and cut off a nice fresh cut, and that should be easier because you won't have all of these little hairs coming off and making it more difficult to get it through your needle. The other thing you can try is if you fold over and make a loop on your thread and hold it kind of like press your fingernail right close to the loop, you can sometimes wiggle that through the eye as well. This one is not working out so well for me. Oh, almost. Okay, so you can see here I've only gotten one of the threads through. So that's not gonna work. I'm just gonna start again over here. And I'll show you that cutting the thread to get a nice clean cut is going to make a big difference in how easy it is to get our thread into our needle. So for this project, we're just going to use a single layer of thread, which means we're not gonna pull this and double it up. We're just gonna leave it hanging loose at one end and use a single layer of thread when we do our sewing. So what we want is our needle at one end and the excess hanging loose. And then we want our knot at the other end of the thread. So one way that we can do this, and this is the way that I use, it's pretty easy. But it does take some getting used to. All you have to do is hold on to the end of your thread, wrap the other side around, and you're forming kind of a little X with the thread. And what's going to happen is you're going to roll this off your finger, and you'll notice that it's twisting in on itself. That's what you want to happen, because that's what is going to create the knot. We're twisting in that little end into the knot itself. Then I just grab this with my other finger and pull, and I should have a nice big stable knot at the end, right at the end of my thread, and that won't come through when I sew it through the paper or fabric. So I'll show you that one more time. I'm holding on to the end, bringing the other side across, making a little X, and twisting it, rolling it off my finger, twisting it inside, and then just grab it and pull. And all of those times that it twists around, that will create a nice knot for us. Another method, and this is actually this is method one. The one that I just showed you now is method two on your handout. This one coming up now is method number one. And what you do is you start at the other end, you start with your needle. So what you wanna do is grab the eye of your needle, kind of as if you were gonna poke somebody, but don't do that. And then you're gonna take the long end of your thread and also hold on to that. So I'm holding on to both the needle and that end of thread. Don't do anything with this one here. You can just ignore that. What you're gonna do now is you're gonna wrap this end of the thread around the needle a few times. It doesn't matter which direction. So I could go forward or I could go the other way, doesn't matter. But you wanna do it at least three times. I would say 3 to 5 times should be good. And then you're gonna slide those loops down and hold on to them between your fingers. And then what you're gonna do is you're going to slide your needle and the rest of the thread, making sure that it doesn't get tangled down on you. Slide it all the way till you get to the end. And again, that's going to make a nice little knot for you, or a nice big knot that won't go right through your fabric when you put it in. This is my cat. She has decided to join us. Hopefully she won't eat the thread. So I'll show you that one more time. And I would suggest practicing this a few times because it's really good to get the hang of it. So that you don't have to relearn it every time you try to do this. So what I'm doing is I'm just holding on to the needle with the pokey side out. Take the end of my thread, the long end where I want the knot to end up. I'm gonna hold on to that as well. Take this and wrap it around my needle. You can slide this down and hold on to it between these two fingers. Another method is actually if you just take it with your other hand and hold on to those loops, and then you can grab the needle from the other hand, and this basically does the same thing. You're just grabbing it with the opposite hand this time. And there you have it, a nice knot.